All right, we're back from our trip, so I have to get to work, edit the video, add this onto the beginning, and then get the video for you. By the way, it's Pi Day, 314, so that's kind of cool. So the video you'll see.
We went to the Dayton Air Force Museum. Highly, highly recommend it. It was free to get in, free admission, free parking. If you haven't been there, you need to go. It was an awesome, awesome trip.
I definitely recommend it too.
Yes.
All right, enjoy this video. Thanks. All right, we're on our way.
Yep, we're on our way in the car.
The Air Force Museum, it's sunny, it's 39, supposed to be 60 today, second week of March. We've got an hour and 34 minute drive. Here we go.
See you soon.
It's our special guest.
Yay.
Oh, we stopped for breakfast.
It's Kroger's bakery. Easy for you to say.
Got some donuts.
Not happy about these fuel prices, but by the time you watch this video, maybe it'll be more. I hope not. We made it. Here we are. Goggles, 1910. This is a wind tunnel designed by Orville Wright, 1916, 160 mile an hour winds. ...1918 wind tunnel. The plane of the Red Baron. This is an early unmanned plane homing missile. It'd take off and then knew where it was going, I guess, through electronics, and the wings would fall off and it would dive right in and blow up whatever it was blowing up. What did I do? You know what you did. You crashed our plane. How are we gonna fix this? What is it?
The hangar where it holds bombs. It looked like it held like 6 bombs.
Wow. So first we were in the early years. So what you've seen is some of the first pictures. And this is the World War II gallery. Less than 0.5% were lost in combat. Wow, that's amazing. What are they, B-26G Marauder? This World War II planes kind of gives you goosebumps. Seeing what they fought with. And surface to surface flying bomb from World War II, unmanned. Look at this missile back here. Flying bombs and rocket developments. V1 and V2. Replica of the first jet engine. So how does it work, Noah?
Well, the air comes in, and it's getting compressed by this compressor, combusted in the combustion chamber, expanded by the turbine, which turns the compressor, and exhausted out the back.
So it goes fast?
Yeah, it goes really fast.
That it dropped the Fat Man atomic bomb on August 9, 1955, 3 days after the atomic attack against Hiroshima.
So this is the plane that dropped the atomic bomb. One of the two.
Eat lunch.
It's a cafe. So we're just done eating. It's kind of like cafeteria food, but it wasn't bad. I thought it was good.
Yeah, it was good. I liked it.
Better than school lunches.
Better than school
Not
lunches.
Not by too much.
So we've seen, it's kind of broke down in like 6 categories or 8 categories or something. So far we've seen the early years and World War II. Next, we've got Korean War and Southeast Asia, and then a big section of the Cold War, and we end up with, what does it say, Presidential Gallery and Research and Development Gallery. So,
cool.
Looking forward to it.
All right.
Going inside the B-29.
Oh, there. Now look at their old headphones.
Yeah. Is this a bomber? B-29, is that a bomber?
Yeah, I think
it is.
There's seats everywhere. So crew tunnel, is that where they slept? Or that's probably how they crawled to get back to the bombs.
Yeah. Oh, here's the payload. Ooh. Is that what Tom Cruise shot down? The Russian MiGs? It's the biggest airplane in the place. What's this one called?
B-52, I think.
So this is the B-52. I'm not sure what we was in earlier. We thought it was a B-52. But this is a B-52, biggest plane in the museum. Look how big that wheel is.
Those visiting the Valkyrie Cafe should use the main staircase or elevator near the entrance.
What?
I ain't gonna be able to get out. There you go. Take a picture or video.
Video.
Eject.
Push the eject button.
Eject.
See if you can get out.
Eject. I made it.
Russian MiG. I don't know if this is the one Tom Cruise was after. Another MiG. Tom Cruise might not like this one either. Goose, goose. All right, finishing up with the Southeast. We did the Korean and the Southeast Asia, and now we're heading into Cold War era. It's really neat here. You guys need to visit. First mass-produced nuclear bomb. So this SR-71 Blackbird goes 2,193 miles per hour. Noah's gonna fly it someday.
Yeah, definitely.
Found Tom Cruise's ship. Or plane, I guess. I think we found the one Tom Cruise was after. Wait, they think this might be the one Tom Cruise was after. Yeah, I think he flew upside down above this one and took a picture of it. I recognize it now. If I was upside down, I'd recognize it better. And I stand corrected. This is the plane Tom Cruise was riding in. It's the one Goose lost his life. I don't think it was in this one. But Tom Cruise come back, got his confidence back, threw this M15, showed these missiles and machine guns to the bad guys, got her done.
Oh.
What did we find out about the Top Gun and Tom Cruise?
I looked it up and they say that they're chasing after fictional MiG-28s that are actually F-5F Tiger IIs.
Huh.
So it's a fake plane that he tries to shoot down.
So now you're going to tell me it wasn't really Tom Cruise flying the plane.
I think he's a pilot.
Yeah. See? Don't be giving me all this. Leaving the Cold War era and heading for the Space Gallery. These are missiles and they're quite impressive, to tell you the truth. Wow. Can't even explain to you how tall these things are. With these gentlemen talking, look how big those missiles are. Is this where they get out the red key or whatever? We're in Air Force One. Eisenhower, Dwight Eisenhower, is president. I don't think he flew the plane.
He might have.
Find it interesting the armrests have ashtrays in them. Oh, I got the where they cook for the president, apparently. Hope you like toast. Presidential toilet for a presidential poopy. Presidential bed, maybe? I don't know. Probably not presidential bed. Oh, nice desks, telephones on the plane. It's probably more like the presidential beds back here. Clocks, where he left from. What time it was going to be when he got there. And here is the working area, apparently. Oh, that was where the presidential poop happened.
There's a phone right here, too.
There's another phone. A lot of phones on this plane for back in the day. Well, we ended up in JFK's presidential airplane, Air Force One.
The padded seats are covers for storage boxes. Contains linen and other objects.
It's not showing us what's in here. I think this was Marilyn Monroe's suite.
Oh, look at this. Yeah. Oh, that was the bathroom.
Oh. Oh, we are going to get to see what's in here. Oh, yeah, TV. Mm. Hey. Bathroom. Yeah. Oh wow, they had it going on. Yeah. JFK had the parties. Huh. Oh. Eisenhower's just had like one seat. JFK's got the party going on.
Look at the old copier.
Map of the U.S. in case he forgets the states.
Yeah, in case he forgets the states, yeah. Got a map of the U.S. He's still got that place up north. Shouldn't be on there, but that's okay. Ohio is. Boy, a lot of seats, a lot more seats than the last one, yeah.
Hello. Another stove area here.
Yeah.
Bathroom.
Oh, yeah, a different eating area. Oh, this was probably the Marilyn Monroe suite. Back here. Uh-huh. Oh. We've seen the presidential planes. Now here's the Rock's plane, apparently. I didn't even know the Rock had a plane. It's a big one. Unmanned combat planes. Leonardo da Vinci display. Here's a sawmill.
He's interested in the way pieces of the human body, which is, after all, very interesting.
He spun that wheel and the saw blades in
the changing conditions that I don't represent our new wheels.
Presidential wing was pretty cool. We got to see the presidential planes. And we head outside, there's a couple airplanes to see outside. And then we're pretty much done for the day. We could have spent a lot more time, but just didn't have it because it's almost closing time. Let's go check them out. Look at the nose on that thing. This is Boeing EC-135 area.
So I think it was worth it. I recommend going to the Air Force Museum if you're anywhere close to it. I thought it was cool. I was surprised how many big atomic and hydrogen bomb replicas, but everything was cool. What'd you like?
I like the spaceship looking ones. They're pretty cool.
I liked it all, I guess.
God.
She's tripping.
We better go. Come to the Air Force Museum. You'll like it. Where does it say? Space flavor. All right, we're back from our trip, and we get ready to try out our Coke. What is it? Space flavored Coke. Let's try them out. It's kind of reddish. You don't remember space being red. Of course, I don't remember last time I was in space, do you?
No.
All right, give it a taste. See what you think.
Tastes a lot like normal Coke.
Like normal Coke?
It's a little different, but I don't.
I taste a little.
What it is.
I taste mine with a little Meteor, Wright, and moon cheese. It's kind of what it reminds me of. That and the kind of cherry with little fizz aftertaste. But
I can see that.
Yeah. All right. Thanks for watching. Like us. Subscribe to us. What else? Bell notification. Yeah, all that. Thanks.